when you're on the screen. When evening falls so hard, I will comfort you.
Staring at the tonsils of Alfie Boe here on Border Crossings, this is the Voice of America, and his version of a classic song, Bridge Over Troubled Water, Simon and Garfunkel, to start off our Friday show on Border Crossings. And you ask yourself, why is he playing an opera song to start off Border Crossings? And I'll tell you, the answer is simple. The singer will be here in just moments. Alfie Boe, who is performing on the Mall in downtown D.C. for a big annual event that takes place every year at Memorial Day, here in the United States, in Washington, D.C. He's here in town from London, and we'll have him in our studios as soon as he can find the door. Right now, we're waiting on him to get into the building, and this is a big building with four sides to it, so we're trying to coordinate his entrance. And once he gets in and gets up to the fourth floor, we will continue with our broadcast and put him on the air. And you'll hear Alfie Boe, and we'll be talking to him. But in the meantime, let's play some requests, because that's what Border Crossings does on a usual basis. And this is a request now from India. Srini Vasan is listening to us in India and says, happy birthday, Larry. And I say happy birthday. And thank you, Srini Vasan, for your thoughtful greeting. He requested this one from Beyonce, and it's called Fever on Border Crossings.
Yeah. much I love you. Never know how much I care. When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear. You give me fever when you kiss me, and fever when you hold me tight. You give me fever in the morning, and fever all through the night. I bet it's so damn sexy. I better put the fever on me. Baby, you're my flame. Now give me fever when the kisses, a fever with a flame in you. Fever, I'm on fire. Fever, yeah, I burn pursuit. Captain Smith and Pocahontas had a very mad affair. When her daddy tried to kill him, she said, "Daddy, hold on to dad." He gives me fever with his kisses, a fever when he holds me tight. Fever, I'm his missus, and daddy, won't you treat him right? Now that you've listened to my story, here's the point that I made. Chicks were born to give you fever, be it Fahrenheit or centigrade. They give you fever when you kiss them, and fever if you live and learn. Fever till you sizzle. What a lovely way to burn. What a lovely way to burn. What a lovely way to burn. Fever till you sizzle. What a lovely way to burn.
Border Crossings
with Larry London
on VOA Music Mix.
See
it's Border Crossings, and welcome to a special Friday show. My name is Larry London. We're listening to the music of one of the world's great voices, a guy who's won a Tony Award for his acting in La Boheme, and he's here in D.C. for a special event that takes place this weekend. We would like to welcome Alfie Boe to the Voice of America. Welcome.
Hi. How are you doing?
I'm all right. Great to have you here.
Thank you so much. That's a great pleasure. Great
what an honor. I've never met a Tony winner, so let me touch. Really? I just want to touch you. Congratulations.
That'll cost you money that now. You know
uh-oh. I got a few dollars. So where's the Tony? That's the obvious question.
That's at home, sort of propping open a door at the moment. No, it's not.
I thought it'd be on the dash of your car. And
I know, exactly. It's on proud display with on the shelf, yeah.
Wow. So, you have a beautiful voice.
Thank you.
Has it always been opera and...
Well, I trained as an opera singer. I went to music college to study a technique of classical training. But I've always been into lots of different types of music, and in particular, rock and roll and country and blues and things like that. So now I'm getting the opportunity to sing more of that repertoire and discover that side in my voice, really.
Yeah, I did. You have quite an array of accomplishments and quite a talented person with a very full resume.
Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just looking at it. You have, your new album is produced by a guy that worked with U2.
You
have sung, Queen songs. You love singing Queen.
Yeah.
But I'm listening, and then you've done some remakes on the new album. But yet you're known for La Boheme and Les Miserables. And...
Yeah, well, I was an opera singer for... I was singing in operas around the world in all the houses for 17 years, 18 years. And then when I got the opportunity to make records as a solo artist, I began to discover the chance of recording music that really you wouldn't associate with me, like the rock and roll, like the blues and the country, that sort of stuff. And it comes from my childhood, really, because as a kid, I'm the youngest of nine kids, we're Irish Catholic family, and we grew up around the house listening to lots of different types of music. My brother was a big Elvis fan, and so I stole all of his records and started rock and rolling with Elvis. And my father was a fan of so many different types of music, from classical to big band to Sinatra to Frankie Lane and Jim Reeves and people like that, and Slim Whitman. And so I used to grow up listening to all this different array of music and artists that it was an education for me, and that's what's transcribed now in my life is that I'm getting the chance to sing all this stuff now.
And you must have a tremendously large fan base, because you appeal to the people who like rock.
Yeah.
And then you're singing the greats, like from Les Miserables.
Well, yeah, I'm very fortunate that I am. My audience is varied and very wide, that from a young generation to the older generation who like it when I sing the classical repertoire, because that's what I do in my concerts as well now, is I always incorporate some classical piece in there, or a couple of pieces to sort of like show them what I used to do and what I still do. It's weird to say what I used to do, but I don't consider myself a crossover artist. Crossover is a very odd terminology for a singer for me. I find that crossover to a lot of people describes a singer crossing over the different genres of music. But to me, it's not like that. To me, it's crossing over to an audience, to a different audience, getting the opportunity to sing rock and roll, blues, country to audience members who might be just into classical music, and getting the opportunity to sing classical music to rock and roll audience, and that sort of thing. And it's a great opportunity to educate people and show them that there's no division between music. Music is just one world for me, and there's no division. It's the same notes, just in different order.
Well, you've got, an autobiography. You've got a DVD live.
I can't even read, and I've written a book. It's crazy.
And you're doing your third album, I guess? It's the third
this
or fourth?
This is my seventh album.
Seventh album?
But nobody knows the other ones.
What are you doing with all the free time you've got?
I'm very fortunate that things are going the way they are, and I'm just sort of grasping at every opportunity that I can to keep going and take it further and conquer the world.
Yeah. You know? Now, I want to ask you the question about Alfie, the name Alfie.
Yeah.
Did that come from the song? Or how, I mean,
no, it came from my mother and father, actually.
Yeah, well, did they like the song?
No. My grandfather was an Alfred. My great-grandfather was an Alfred. My father was Alfred.
Ah,
and so I was named after
lineage.
Him. Yeah, exactly.
They're keeping
exactly.
it going.
And my little boy, he's Alfie now.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You have, I think, two kids.
I've got two kids, a little girl called Gracie and a boy called Alfie who gets in a lot of trouble at the minute. But
does he sing?
He makes quite a big noise. Yeah, he does, I've got to say.
At 3 a.m, right?
Exactly. Right at the wrong times.
Yeah. Well, I wanted to, you know, we want to talk about the fact that you're here for a very special reason.
Yeah.
And it's not only, you know, to expand the horizons of your fan base with a new album releasing in America, but it's also to honor the military, because this weekend is a very special and important occasion in American history.
It is. You know, the Memorial weekend is very special for me. We have something similar in the UK as well, Festival of Remembrance, but being given the opportunity to celebrate the lives and memory, you know, remember the lives of the veterans who fought in the battles around the world. It's an amazing thing. I mean, we are, you know, as celebrities, as people who go on television and go on radio, and your face is out there all the time and things like that. It's a very humbling, event to be a part of, because we're not the stars. We're the people that are the stars of the weekend, and the people that need to be celebrated are the veterans, and that's what we want to try and do in the form of music, in the form of spoken word. You know, we really need to remember people that have fought for our freedom.
And freedom is not something that's exclusive to the United States. Everybody around the world is in search of freedom, in hope and pursuit of freedom.
Exactly. Yeah.
So no matter what culture and what country you're from, it's something we all strive for. And then, you know, I mean, to honor the troops here in the United States, and to have somebody, you live in the United States.
I do. Yeah. I live over in Salt Lake City at the moment. We're moving to LA. We're gonna get a place over there because I miss the beach.
I don't blame you.
But no, my wife is American. My wife was born in Anchorage, Alaska. And so we've been over here for many years, and it's a wonderful place to be.
Now, how did you meet?
I feel very patriotic, you know, even though it's not my nation, my national country, but I feel very patriotic about America. I love it so much.
Now, how did you meet a beautiful young lady from Anchorage, Alaska?
Prison. No,
prison. Okay.
No,
witness protection.
No. I was working in San Francisco. On a production on La Boheme, actually, and we were rehearsing over there and doing previews for the show, and my wife Sarah was rehearsing in the building that I was in as well, and we met during a break time, and I was trying to push this tea bag into one of these thermos cups, you know, one of these trucker cups, which had a huge base to it but a narrow opening at the top. I'd gone through about 6 or 7 tea bags, you know, and I couldn't get them into the top, and there was covered in tea, you know. And I just turned and I looked at this girl, and the first thing I said to her was, "You can't get a decent cup of tea around here." And it seemed to work. So
yeah,
we got two
that's
kids
a great
now,
line. So. Right, so two kids later, and a lot of tea.
And a lot of tea. Yeah.
Now, have
but you can
you,
get a decent cup of tea? Yeah,
that's right. Yes, you can. It's not easy, but you can. So, I mean, when you go home, do you ever sing the music that you've sung on stage, or what are you doing at home?
At home, usually changing diapers, and you know, but
things
no,
dads do.
Yeah, I do. I do sing at home quite a lot. Actually, I walk around the house and sing the songs off my album, or if I'm preparing for a concert, I'll go through the repertoire, and then it's usually interrupted by my son or daughter coming and telling me to keep quiet. It's too loud, you know, that sort of thing. So.
Well, I won't interrupt you, and I won't ask you to keep quiet. Could you do something for us?
I'm not going to tap dance like you.
No, don't tap dance like Maya. There's no taps. You won't tear up our floor, our fake wood floor.
Yeah, I'll sing a song for you. This is. Okay. This is a beautiful song. It's an American folk song called Rank Strangers, and it tells a story of a Civil War soldier returning to his home, and all his friends have been killed in battle. He's lost his family. They've moved on, or they've been killed in war, and so he's returning to his hometown, he's a stranger in his home. You know, he doesn't know anybody, and nobody knows him. So this is Rank Strangers. I wandered again to my home in the mountains, where at youth's early dawn I was happy and free. I looked for my friends, but I never could find them. I found they were all rank strangers to me. Everybody I met seemed to be a rank stranger. No mother or dad, not a friend could I see. They knew not my name, and I knew not their faces. I found they were all rank strangers to me. They've all moved away, said the voice of a stranger, to a beautiful land by the bright crystal sea. Some beautiful day I will meet them in heaven, where no one will be a stranger to me. Everybody I met seemed to be a rank stranger. No mother or dad, not a friend could I see. They knew not my name, and I knew not their faces. I found they were all rank strangers to me. Everybody I met seemed to be a rank stranger. No mother or dad, not a friend could I see. They knew not my name, and I knew not their faces. I found they were all rank strangers to me. I found they were all rank strangers to me.
Beautiful. Wow. And I see you pour your heart into it, too.
Thank you.
That was beautiful. Yeah. Lovely. They're clapping all around the world for you, right? They're going crazy.
Bless you, man. Thank
Alfie Boe is in our studios. Now, the new album is Storyteller.
Yeah.
And how did you pick the songs that you put on the new album?
Well, there's a number of songs that are always on my list of greats that I really want to try and to put out there. And so you sort of whittle them down. You present them to the record company. They have a list. Your management have a list. And then you sort of, it's like a jigsaw, basically. You take songs from their list and songs from my list and then you basically make an album, and that's how it works. And the majority of the songs on there were all from my list because theirs were rubbish. But no, I'm joking. My manager's looking at me now. What are you saying?
What? Now, you do so many things, and you do them all so well. Do you have a favorite part of the business? Because you act, and you sing, and everything else that you do, I mean...
Radio interviews.
Radio, yeah. This is your favorite part right now.
This is a favorite part.
Getting up early and having to come in and talk.
I think standing on stage and seeing people's faces and seeing the response that you get and what you actually do as a performer, you know, how much entertainment, how much joy, how much sort of escapism you give to the audience, you know, that they want to be taken out of their world a little bit, and whether it's a memory that they want to have or a... You know, they want to forget something during the day. That's what we get the chance to do for them. You know, mm-hmm. and it's a great job. I love it. You know,
yeah, because I know that when you're singing, you know, for an album in a concert, let's say you did the Royal Albert Hall concert.
Yeah,
you know, and that's tremendous. That in and of itself has got to be thrilling. And you perform for the Queen at the Queen's Jubilee.
Yeah, that's which right. Yeah.
Did she say anything to you? I mean, did you?
She said you were rubbish.
Yeah.
No, she was great. She was a lovely lady. She's uh-huh. She's an absolute diamond, literally diamond jubilee.
Diamond jubilee.
But Her Majesty came up to me afterwards, and we had a short, brief chat, and she was saying how busy I was and where I was going next, and just about to start a tour of the US, and she was saying, wow, you must travel a lot, you must get so tired from traveling, and it's but in comparison to how much traveling she does, and as an 80-year-old lady, I mean, it's nothing.
Now, when you get to sing on stage, you're yourself, but when you're acting, you're someone else.
Yeah. That was the beauty of playing Jean Valjean, you know, in Les Miserables. You really step into that character and you let that character speak. Mm-hmm. You know, you don't, there's no sort of trying to manifest that character and saying you have to really embody everything that that guy mm-hmm. has gone through and is going through, you know, and that was, I related a lot to the guy. I related a lot to Jean Valjean and his fight for justice and he doesn't like injustice and he fights to protect mm-hmm. the innocent and the smaller person it's a great role to embody and great role to do. Mm-hmm. Lovely music.
Did you see the film?
No. I haven't actually seen the film because I've been traveling so much. I've been on tour.
I thought you'd be saying, Hugh, I could have done it different.
Well, yeah,
I could have done it better, Hugh.
we can all do different things to roles that we've played, but I think Hugh Jackman did an incredible job. You know, mm-hmm. And myself and Hugh are just one. You know, we're just one of many Jean Valjeans that are going to be there throughout the world, and there's wonderful people that bring something new to the role, you know, and Hugh brought something new to it, I brought something new to it, and the guy that does it next will bring something new, and that's why it's been running for so long, and that it keeps reinventing itself in a way.
What do you do when you're on stage and someone's phone goes off or something happens? How do you handle that as a stage performer?
I usually make a big deal of
it.
I normally do.
and embarrass them
and then take their phone off them and bring it up on stage and then take pictures of all the band and things like that, then hand them back the phone. but it's fun. You can't get too fussy about things like that because it's real life. People mm-hmm. do leave the phones on, and
that's true.
And it's real life. So if you're too precious about it, then I think you're probably in the wrong business.
Now, you, as I mentioned, wrote an autobiography, a book about yourself. What was the hardest part to write? I mean, what did you struggle with most writing your story? Whether you should talk about it, shouldn't talk about it, putting it in a book?
Yeah, there was a number of things that I wanted to put across there of not to sort of like paint a bad picture of my time getting into the business, but mm-hmm. there were hard times. There was a lot of struggle in there, and that was quite strange to drag it all back up again and talk about. But there's hard times for everybody in every business that they go through. If they want to be a success, they're going to have to go through the tough times before they make it better, you know.
Right.
But I personally, one of the hardest things for me was writing about my father. You know, it was he passed away 15 years ago now, so that was quite hard for me mm-hmm. to go through and to really go into detail of the time of his lead up to his death, then his death, and then the time after that, and talking about my past, my childhood with him, and things like that. So that was very personal, and I never thought that I would be putting anything down like that in a book for the nation to see. And
yeah, it's kind of revealing. That's
it is. Yeah, yeah,
letting people into really who you are. And
but if you're going to write a book, you've got to do it.
Yeah, you know? I guess so. If it's not fiction,
no, exactly. But it's a horror story, the rest of the book.
We're talking with Alfie Boe, who's our guest here on The Voice of America in Washington, D.C. For how long are you here? Just for the weekend?
I'm here
for
until Monday, yeah, until Memorial Day. So, yeah, I'm here doing the show on Sunday. Then I have to fly over to Chicago and do a little bit of work there, and then back home for a couple of days, and then back out on the road. So, yeah, it's a whirlwind trip, but I'm taking in the most of it as I can. You know?
And this is your first concert with the memorial, the National Memorial Day concert,
yeah.
The first time?
Yeah, first time, I hope.
What are you going to sing?
I'm singing Bring Him Home from Les Miserables, so that should be... Should be nice. I think it should go down well.
That is, I mean, you know, it's going to be an exciting event, as it always is here in D.C.,
yeah,
and it's going
yeah.
to be wonderful to have you as a part of it.
Bless you. Thank you.
No,
thank
absolutely. You. Now, for people who are just meeting you for the first time, or your fans who might be tuned in around the world, how do people go and get the new CD? Is it on Amazon and all that?
It's on Amazon. It's going to be in the shops as well. So I think it's easier to maybe order it online. You know, it's on the music sites out there as well. So, but Amazon is the big site to check out for my album. So. Mm-hmm.
And how about your website?
My website, alfieboe.com, I think. I never go on it, so I never know the
address.
You don't
log on.
It's terrible, isn't it? I should know my own address and my own website. It's ridiculous.
Do you Twitter and tweet and Facebook and all that
stuff?
I
do Twitter. I think I have a Facebook page. I don't do it myself because I'm useless with all that thing. You know, I've only just figured out how to make a phone call.
It's weird. You know? Just got a cell phone,
exactly.
Right?
But no, I get, you know, there's a number of people that are that are in control of all that, so all the Twitter and things. And I think the Twitter is just at Alfie Boe, with no reference to Les Miserables or anything.
Yeah.
It's just at Alfie Boe.
What are your other goals? I mean, what you've accomplished so much in theater. You know, I read that you were on Broadway. Have you done West End in London?
I've done the West End. I did the West End a few years back now.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from wanting to be a presenter on Voice of America,
oh well, hey, I'm going.
I would like to be.
It's yours. You got it.
I don't know. I want to play so many different venues, you know, and just get around the world and sing to as many people as I possibly can. But people say, you know, what's your ambition? What do you want to do next? And I never know because I don't know what the following day is going to bring. You know, so I just try and concentrate on what I've got to do at that particular moment in time and try and do it to the best of my ability and then face the following day.
Face the reviews.
Exactly.
Is there a role you want to play, a dream role?
You know, I find that funny because sometimes roles, you can't really go out looking for characters to play for roles. Mm-hmm. You know, it's very strange, but they find you. Like, when I wasn't looking at playing Jean Valjean in Les Miserables.
Mm-hmm.
It just so happened that the offer for the job came about, and when I discovered the role, when I discovered the music, it was almost like a fire had ignited inside of me, and that it was the perfect time, the perfect role for me to be playing at that particular moment in my life.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that that's how you discover roles. I don't think you have a wish list that you want to tick off, play that now, because I think it becomes too impersonal.
Right.
You know,
right.
You really have to find out where you are in your life to be able to play a character.
Hmm.
It's a funny one.
And now that you have the new CD, it's out.
Yeah.
So then comes the tour. That's the part of the other side of the business. They release the CD, you have to tour and promote it.
Yeah.
Do you have plans to tour internationally? And if so, where?
Yeah, we got a US tour coming up at the beginning of next year, and which is going to be a lot of fun. We're going everywhere. I think we start on the West Coast, then we're playing Washington again. We're solidifying the venue here. I'm not sure where we are at the moment, but we got the West Coast, we got the East Coast, we got Central America, so it's going to be a big old trek, big old trek. But I love it. I love hanging out with the band on the bus, and it's fun.
Do you have favorite places you want to perform in? I mean, internationally, like
internationally,
in Africa or Asia.
Oh my goodness. I would love to. I'd love to play more in Australia. I think, you know, Australia is a wonderful part of the world, and I've played there a couple of times at the Opera House, but to get out to to Australia or Asia. Japan, I'd love to go and play there, and mm-hmm. it'd be amazing opportunities to take my music over that side if I can.
Well, Japan's listening right
Russia
now.
Russia as well. Russia.
I'd oh, there you go. There we have a Russian service. We'll see if we can hook you up.
Thank you.
And get you a show out there. Alfie Boe is on our show today. It is the Voice of America. And Storyteller is the new CD.
Yeah.
And you said it's number 7 in your collection of CDs. Why'd you call this Storyteller?
Well, you know, it's more of a description of who we are as artists. I think, you know, we are basically just storytellers. You know, we're you know, as a singer, you portray a story. You're telling a tale in the form of music. So that's pretty much why we called it Storyteller. You know,
simple.
That's all I am.
Right to the point. Can you tell us a story? Another song? Could you? Would you be willing
another
to?
Song? Yeah,
another
yeah,
song.
Another, wow,
a story
my goodness.
With music.
Wow. Let me think. What would you like me to sing? I could do a bit of Bringing Home if you want.
You know what? Well, you could do that. Or, you know, my favorite is Phantom of the Opera. And I read where
really?
You had been in Phantom of the Opera.
I'd sung a bit of Phantom of the Opera.
And I don't want to put you on the spot. Whatever you want, whatever feels most comfortable to you.
I think I sang a bit of Phantom years ago. But I can't remember any of it now. Sorry. let me think what I could
or
do.
Or you could do the song you're going to do, you know, tomorrow.
Bring Him Home.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
That
I
would be beautiful.
Try,
give us a little preview.
A little bit. Okay. Cool. Let me have a go.
All right. Alfie Boe.
I'll have a bit of water if that's
yes, absolutely. Absolutely. And by the way, the new CD is called Storyteller from Alfie Boe, so please do pick up a copy.
Here we go. God on high, hear my prayer. In my need, you have always been there. He is young. Afraid, let him rest, heaven blessed. Bring him home, bring him home, bring him home. He's like the sun I might have known. If God had granted me a son, the summers die one by one. How soon they fly on. And I am old and will be gone. Bring him peace, bring him joy. He's young, he's only a boy. You can take, you can give. Let him be, let him live. If I die, let me die. Let him live. Home, bring him home, bring him home.
Wow. Wow.
Thank you.
Wow. I am not worthy. That is beautiful. Absolutely wonderful.
Thank you.
Marvelous.
Thank you. Bless you. Cheers.
That was great. And I can't wait to hear it tomorrow with a full orchestra.
Thank you.
That would be great.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Beautiful voice. Alfie Boe is here in our studios on The Voice of America. What a special treat. And I know that, you know, you're no stranger to the United States, and I'm not sure how often you've been to D.C., but the next time you're here, come back and see us again.
I would love to, man. I'd love to. I love D.C. so much. I've played the Birchmere a couple of times in a bit of a rock and roll way, and it was fun, man. It was so much fun. The audience here, the people here are beautiful. I love them so much.
Well, there's millions who are looking forward to your performance on, you know, PBS. On the big Memorial Day concert, which
I feel like I'm on home turf. Do you know what I mean?
Yes, you're second home. You got two, so you're always home. And thank you very much for coming on The Voice of America again.
Pleasure. Thanks a lot, Larry.
Alfie Boe is our guest here on The Voice of America. I'm Larry London. Stay tuned. There's more music coming your way. Crossing's Alfie Boe with his rendition of an Elvis song. Thank you for tuning in to our program. Thanks again, Alfie Boe. You know what I'm going to do right now is open up the phone lines. I promised I'd give away the Now 46 CD. We'll take caller 10 at 202-619-2077. Caller 10 right now wins the Now 46 CD and the VOA t-shirt that we've been giving away all week. Our last calling giveaway, last phone in to win giveaway. Then we go to Facebook on Monday. One more request, Sammy Kiprop, who sent us those postcards earlier in the week, the happy birthday postcards. He has a happy birthday song he wants played for me. And so I play it with appreciation. Sammy, thank you very much for your thought on my birthday. And this is called Come Early Morning, Don Williams, as we look for the 10th caller on Border Crossings.
I've been walking in the moonlight, tripping in the starlight, Lord, and I'm feeling down. Walking in the shadows, sneaking down a side road. Come early morning, I'll be there on the edge of town. I was a thinking, thinking about a good thing, thinking about a sweet gleam in my honey's eyes. I was a sinking, feeling kind of lonesome. Come early morning, I'll be home at my honey's side. I have drifted
side. And I've been tempted, tried and troubled. Come early morning, I'll be home and satisfied. Sunshine, make me have a good time, Lord, when I'm feeling blue. I couldn't refuse her, well, I couldn't misuse her. Come early morning, I'll be home with my honeydew. I have drifted up across the mountain. I have stumbled down the other side. Satisfied.
Border Crossings on the Voice of America come early morning. Come early tomorrow morning, I'll be celebrating my 25th birthday for the second time. But thank you for the request from Don Williams fans around the world, namely Sammy Kiprop Kitour, who wrote in and requested that song. So thank you very much. Appreciate the greeting. We are thrilled to be able to play your request. And also thrilled, equally as happy and excited, to be able to congratulate Chris Mudo in Rwanda. Chris Mudo is the 10th caller, and that means he has won the Now 46 CD and the VOA t-shirt that we've been giving away on Border Crossings for the past month. We've got another week's worth of these Now 46 CDs to give away, courtesy of EMI and our friends at Now That's What I Call Music. And if you want to win on Monday or Tuesday, you need to have access to Facebook, because we'll be doing it with our Facebook Word of the Day. Facebook.com/VOA Larry London. So sign up for Facebook and you can fan or like our page over the weekend, and you won't miss the word of the day that way. You'll be sure and get it, the word of the day. And then when I ask for it, if you're the first caller with the word of the day every day next week starting Tuesday, you'll win the Now 46 CD and the VOA t-shirt that we've got just for you in your size and color. Thanks very much for listening to Border Crossings. Thank you, Nelson, for sitting in for Lee all week. And to Ted and to Mary and Yvonne and to all of our good friends. And Carl and to Carol and to Alfie Boe for coming on Border Crossings. And thanks to you for listening. You're the most important part of this whole party. Without you, there's no us. Thank you very much for tuning in. I'm Larry London. Happy Memorial Day weekend. I'll see you live in studio on Tuesday. This is Border Crossings on the VOA Music Mix Network. Bye.
It's coming up on 16 hours Universal Time. We now say goodnight to our listeners in Asia until we return at 22 hours Universal Time on 5.89, 5.91, 7.48, 7.57, and 12.15 megahertz shortwave. We also say goodnight to listeners in the Middle East and North Africa until 20 hours Universal Time on 7.48 and 9.48 megahertz shortwave. For listeners in Africa, Africa News Tonight is next on 4.93, 6.08, and 15.58 megahertz shortwave, as well as on 909 and 1530 kilohertz medium wave to South Africa. You can also hear our programs on the internet at voanews.com. This is the Voice of America.
Shauna Renee.